thank you for having Choose TV over today. Growing up in LA, you must have been surrounded by a lot of culture and a lot of industry music.
Yeah.
Did you know that this is what you were going to do? How did you get started?
I always knew that music was a part of what I was going to do. I think I always would write songs as a kid. I just naturally would just write songs. I naturally could hear harmony really well. It wasn't until like after school I really realized that it just was something that I should focus on. People were seeing me write songs for other people and they're like, you know, but you look like an artist, you know, this music is really good, and but I don't know who could sing it. So it just became really apparent that I just was just ready for me to do my own thing now.
You've written for some other pretty big names too, right?
Yeah.
Don't be afraid, drop those names.
I definitely had an amazing opportunity to work with people like Timbaland and Mary J. Blige, and I wrote Starshell's very first single. She's Mary J. Blige's first artist. I got to write with, you know, people like Kiki Palmer and Dr. Dre and, Swiss Beats. It's a lot of really, really cool people, but I'm really excited. I was working with them writing, you know, for other projects, but I'm really, really excited to be working on my stuff now.
Do you know when you've written a hit?
You know when a song is really, really special, when immediately everybody, you know, gravitates to it. There's certain songs where you're like, oh, I like this, this is cool. But then there's those couple of songs where everybody just feels touched. So I can judge by everyone else that like that should be a big song.
Well, I've been jamming to Inside Out all morning,
yay,
no lie. How did that song come about?
I think when people, you know, they see me, I don't think people know what to expect. And I like that. I like the element of surprise, and I like being able to just turn people's expectations of life, myself, of whatever it is, just turn it inside out, think outside the box.
All right, well, we're ready to check out your shoes. Let us invade your closet.
Yes, let's go.
Well, my first impression here is that you are incredibly organized.
Huh.
Girl, what's up with that?
Well, you know, like when you're in a rush all the time, like living this type of lifestyle, you never know. Sometimes it's like super last minute, you have to do a show. Like literally that happened like 3 or 4 days ago. So it helps save me a lot of time and a lot of stress and frustration. If it's really easy, I can think in my head, okay, this jacket is next to that. And I know that I didn't lose anything. And then if it's gone, I know if it's gone because it's organized. So it saves a lot of time and worry. Let's see, these have a story. Now, I thought about cleaning them up, but I chose not to. There's a reason behind this. I don't know if you've ever seen my video, but it was my very first video. It's called Inside Out. If you haven't, you can go check it out on Vivo. But these were the boots that I was like kicking around all the dust and in my red jacket and in my little whatever bikini top thing I'm wearing.
Yeah, you were really rocking out in these, if
yeah,
I remember correctly.
I was. So I thought about cleaning them off. I was like, no, I'm gonna keep the dust forever.
Show me which of these shoes you've worn on stage.
Of course, I've worn my Docs. Docs are always super easy to dance on stage with. These, I actually wore these on the Carson Daly Show. I performed with the speakers. So if you don't know who the speakers are, you need to go check them out. And I wore these shoes. I was like in grunge hour. These are really cool. I wore these in my first showcase. I had like all the people from when I first got signed, all the people from the label came out. And I just thought they were cool because they light up. You remember when we were kids, like we had the little
yes,
light up sneakers?
I had pink and green ones.
Yeah, I had a few. I don't even remember my, they might have been like Beauty and the Beast or something like that. I love these. I wore these to Coachella when I just left. These are like some of my favorites because, you know, I'm like a leopard head. I'm actually like animal print, you know.
Right, a little rawr.
Yeah, I have a lot. If you just look around, it's like everywhere.
Do you have a favorite pair here in the closet?
Honest to God, these go with everything. We can glam these up, we can dress these down. These are my go-to bad boys. I can dance in them, I can get sexy in them. Trust me, I can.
All right, let's see the rest of your shoe collection.
Cool. This is kind of like my overflow section.
How about those rhinestone covered,
those
velvetness there?
They look really, really cool on stage, you know? If you're on stage, anything like bright or shiny and stuff, so those accent a lot of really cool outfits. And when I'm on stage, a lot of times I have my dancers, so I'll stay in the doc section. But then when I'm by myself, like I'm doing a lot of like gay events, and it's just me by myself, so I'll just pull out, you know, my heels for the boys.
You have some pops of color down here too. What
do
those go with?
These are perfect because they go with everything.
Oh wow.
I like the blocks of color because it, you know, it's in my hair. I figure if all the color is in my hair, I'll match with something in the outfit. So these are kind of the same way. Let's see what else. These are cool. I love these because they are also, you know, skin tone. They match with like almost everything.
Well, NiRe, thank you so much for letting us invade your closet.
That's right.
Where can we keep up with you?
www.nireallday.com. Everyone wants to be the light of the party. So grab a